When I won't I. Oh. E equals Grum C squared. I like it, mate. I like it. Well, I tell you what, in fairness, Elegon, I mean, this we'd be able to knock this up ever so quickly. If it works. I mean, can I do one side, mate? Do you think I'll be okay doing what I'm doing? Or does it all rely on all the pillars being constructed simultaneously? Bondit and Scarfer. Okay, that row with the first upside down ramps. Yeah, so this is row one, isn't it? And you're saying bring me, what was it you said? Six out, wasn't it? So I can only come out as far as one, two, well, I can only, well, hang on, six. Hang on, Elegon, that can't be right, mate. Six is going to bring me to here. We got any more of those corner blocks? I suppose we better put the corner blocks in, otherwise it will always be wondering, oh, it's because. Let's craft some of those. Stop. No, that's what I'm thinking. I'm kind of figuring you don't mean six out. You just mean a total of six blocks, don't you? So it's essentially three out. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So I've got it up. Good, good. Stop! You get any work done today, Elegon? You alright over there, mate? There's no pressure, alright, sir? If it all goes wrong, we'll just give you a big cuddle. No one will laugh at you. After a couple of years, anyway. Let's actually make sure everything's done. No block shall be missed. In case it's the block that would have saved Elegon's. Oh, hang on a sec. Oh, no, yeah, we'll be okay. Elegon's reputation there. Oh, look at it. Look how fast we're building it. It's going up really well, guys. Quite excited. I need some more of those concrete corners. Let's just make a few of those. All happy so far, right? Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Lord. She's not going to be able to speak. I can tell. She's expecting something terrible, weren't you, Fortune? She's been sitting there with it typed out, finger on the return button for like half an hour. I'm going to kill him. I'm going to kill him. If there's a big fluffy walrus, I'm going to murder him. I'm going to hunt him down. How fucking awesome is that? Seriously? You all need to go and pray to your new goddess that is Sky, all right? So this is three, right, Elegon? Or is it? Hang on, actually, no, it's only two, I think. I can come out, I'm coming out another one, right? Yeah, one more. Oh, hang on, or am I? Yeah, yeah, no, I am. One more. In fact, technically two more, yeah? That is more than amazing, mate. Die, I want! You see? I told you there'd be a point in being a grump star. Admittedly, right up until now, not at all, but... So I suppose when Skye becomes like, well, if she's not already and she's keeping it quiet, world famous, you'll all be able to say you've actually been a part of an original Skye production. Can I come out one more, Elagon? I think I'm supposed to, aren't I? I don't think that counts as. One more block, mate, yeah? I'll wait to see if Ele oh, was Elagon there? Bows to the Skye. Ah, oh, Skye, you're a magical lady, honestly. One more, right? You happy with this? Microbe starts status on my CV. Oh dear. So Miss Simpsey, thank you for the interview. Could you just explain this small part of your application? What exactly is a Grumstar? Oh dearie me. You can whip out the photograph now. I think that's right. So by my reckoning, that is block three. Right. So, shall we move on to stage two of Elagon's How to Build a Grum Pyramid? Step three, add the support beams between the pillars. I used upside down ramps as well. This is my. It's never going to work, Elagon. I mean, if it does, tell you what, mate, I take my fucking hat off to you. I'll go and buy a hat just to wear it so I can take it off. So what you're saying here is you're putting one of these on that essentially. Oh, hang on. Actually, how are you doing that? Thinking about it, you're doing that, aren't you? Is that right? Yeah, I think that's right. Shall I build it equally from each side? That would probably make a lot more sense, wouldn't it? Oh, no. Let me have a look. Oh, God, I can't see squat. So this side is the. You're doing that, right? Is that right? I ain't got bloody clue, geezer. I ain't got bloody clue, mate. Oi, oi, Savaloy! Yep, that looks right. Right, we can now progress. Oh no, hang on, we need to do the other one. You can add another normal ramp on top of it. Hang on, I read that having guild leader or officer on your CV actually helps. It does if your boss is into WoW. Let me know when you need a pull boy. Let's go back up. Are we doing all right, Elagon? Are you okay? Have I ballsed it up yet? Are you content? Can't believe I'm actually working for Elagon. How the fuck did this come about? He's flipped the tables on me somehow. He's a master. He's a master summit. There we go. I mean, is there anything to stop me doing that all the way round, Elagon? Or shall I just stick to the one side for the time being? Do you think it might be worth me sort of doing the two edges? Doing good. Cheers. The boss has said I'm doing well, folks. Boss, could I have a cup of coffee yet? Is it time for a break? You're working me very hard here, man. Step four, add the ramps on top of the support beam. Add the next pieces on the pillar to support the next row. Now, this is the one I can't understand. I can't quite make it out, Elagon. I have no idea what I'm doing here. Add the ramps on top of the support beam. Let's go and have a little look. I am building at night, Elagon. I hope you can take that into account. So what you're how far down can I come? Just a couple. I mean, how many of these am I doing? Should I just do like a row at a time? Should I sort of like do this? Oh shit, now what happens over him? Boss! What happens over here, mate? I can see what I need to do, but I'm not entirely sure that... See, what I need now is to do these... Oh no, that's the wrong block, innit? I need to do that, right? I think that's what you're telling me to do. Oh shit, I'm out of bloody concrete. Oh, that's bollocks, that is, mate. Yeah, I can't quite envision how we do this bit, because we kind of already had the corner built over here, didn't we? Oh, it's very high. It does look goddamn cool, Elegon. I tell you what, mate, I'm thinking of just leaving it and just saying, well, there's the pyramid we're constructing, and people go, wow, dude, that is so cool. Yeah, we'll definitely do one side, Elegon. Yeah, definitely. I'm not sure how to do the corner, though, mate. The next horde, let me have a look, is... the next problem is 341, which is dog day. Now, have we got any bloody concrete? Let's go and do some mining tomorrow. We'll do some spins now. The beauty of this, of course... Oh, I do
stream has been up for 1 hour, 12 minutes, 31 seconds.
Wait. Oh, that's not good. That's not the nice sort of burp you have after a beer. That's the sort of burp that's telling you there's things happening down below. I want concrete ramps. This is made a load of concrete ramps. Screw them. Let's get cooking, sir.
Moving.
Oh, there's a rumble in the grum jungle. I'm telling you. Oi. What? There we go. All right. Let's take this. Pull that back. We're gonna go hunting for stone. All right. So I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna get it all smelting up. Quite excited by this, Elegon. This is like doing Lego. I feel like my father is giving me very explicit instructions on how to build a beautiful and amazing thing. I'm very appreciative for this memorable experience you're giving me, sir. Need more wood than that. In fact, we will definitely need more wood than that, won't we? That's quite a lot of stone, actually. There we go. All right, so let's leave that. Let's go get a load of stone from... we'll go to Bruni's hole, I think, because it would be nice to also get... God, that pickaxe has been battered. Can you not stack that with that? There we go. Clawhammer axe, that's all we kind of need, isn't it? We'll put the frames in there with a shovel. That's my normal sort of carry or travelling loadout, isn't it? So... let's just go and pop Magnum ammo away. We'll quickly do some spin. God, it's already 3 o'clock, look. I'm not sure what it is. It's not like a, I don't know. I'd love to say it was just, I don't know. I reckon I'm still not shaking whatever the flip I had all those weeks ago. I haven't felt right since then. really notice it. I just sort of ignore it. So I have to say, there's a gurgling down below that should not be a gurgling, mate. Oh, it should not be doing what it's doing. No, this room is, there's an odour that is very manly. That's one way of putting it. Oh, dearie me. You did not want to put your head underneath the duvet last night. Let's put it that way. Quickly flick it over the girlfriend's head. Oh, dearie me. Boys will be boys. There's nothing funnier than a fart, is there? Come on, let's be honest. Farts are pretty funny. Quickly down under. What's that? That's why cannabis is king. What? Why? Oh. Because it... Oh, I'm not sure what you mean by that. Let's just throw this back in here. Shall we make another axe? Because that one's not looking that great, is it? So let's maybe say take two axes. Let's break this one down. Oh, did I only make one? That's a bit shit. Okay, not to worry. Have a little bit more food. Do you want a spin, or should we just get on with it? Who wants a spin? That's the worry, to be honest, Sky. I don't think it's anything I've had to eat. So it might just be a bit allergy. I don't know, mate. I just don't know. I just don't know what it is. Where's the bike? Okay. Now, where am I going? We're probably okay to go this way, aren't we? Yeah, what I'll do is we'll make sure we've got, like, loads of concrete before we carry on construction. Because there's nothing worse than sort of doing it than having to stop and go back and... Right. Is this the right way? East. East's correct, right? This takes me to the quarry, yeah? I think it does. Whoa. Oh, it does, yeah. You're right, Ratneck. That's terrible, Rob. I don't like spitting, mate. I don't like spitting. It's something that it has, yeah. It's terrible. You shouldn't spit. It's very naughty. Spitting has it results in an unnecessarily Hulk-like rage within me. It's unstoppable in its power, to be quite honest. Right, we'll do a quick. I'm going to just close down Elagon's epic build instructions in the vain hope that. The wheel will still function. It did earlier. There we go. Right, let's do a couple of quick spins. I'm going to go and grab myself a drinky piece. First up is Silverwolf. Ladies, have you got this or would you like me to do them? Good luck, Silver. Next up is Triggers. Good luck, Triggers. Oh, very nice. Now let's just make sure it actually was. Sorry. Getting all eager to carry on with my build, look. Level 2! Good luck, Triggers! Oh! All the way, dude! All the way to level 3! Okay, are you ready? This could be it, folks. The ever elusive Golden Grub Bob. Oh, so close. Well, it's a nice power, but it's not the Golden Grub Bob, I'm afraid, but. Well done, Triggers. 250 GBs in the bank. Not bad. Next up is Shmeggy. Good luck, Shmeggy. It's a sunny. Actually, while this is spinning, I think I actually understand how to do the corner. I think I've just suddenly had a bit of a... I think I've just had a bit of a revelation, actually. Wait until I get back to chat. Hang on, because I can't see chat when I'm doing this. Beast Runner, one last spin. Good luck, mate. Let's move my chat window back. Oh, no!
That is one big pile of shit.
Sorry, mate. At least it takes something home, even if it is a pile of shit. Yeah, hang on, let me bring everything back then. I think... Oh, hang on, what was that? Mr. Duck Shoot... Oh, Elegon, that's very generous of you. You're more than welcome, mate. I think I've just come up with a way to do it. And I think you're right. I think we have to do... If I make sure I've not gone any further than 3 from the corner, so we're midway between the corner and that second pillar as we turn the first 90-degree corner, we'll know if it's working anyway, won't we? So... My only concern is, once we've got to that point, exactly how we then move up the pyramid. So I think I'm okay for now. And more importantly, thank you, because I'm just looking now at your instructions as well. I think I can figure it out. But if you want to come over, Elegon, more than welcome, more than welcome. Trust me. The only thing that I'm a little bit... I mean, I don't think it's going to make any difference, but like you quite rightly say, your pillars are 7 high, mine are 8, but technically that shouldn't make any difference. It shouldn't make any difference. Although I do suppose once we get to the top of the pyramid, it does effectively mean there is an extra block there. I don't know. A lot could go wrong, couldn't it? But you know what? It's good fun. The most important thing is it is good fun doing this. So, right. Oh, shit, 12-57, Elegon, 17, Grum. To be sure, don't just add row by row. Add one to the pillar, then one to the pillar two. Then the second one to pillar one, then the second to pillar two, until the gap is closed. All right, so keep moving inwards is what you're saying. Right. Okay, it's 1-wall, 7-pillar, or 2-wall, 8-pillar, or 5-wall, 10-pillar. Yeah, it won't make any difference, would it? Right, let's go and see if we can find... oh, my lord. Can't really say no to that, can I? Sorry, mate. That felt brutal. That felt brutal. I feel horrible. It was sitting in my bumhole. Maybe that's what's making it smell. uh, Go to the doctor. I got a deer up my ass. Tell her to get out. Oh my lord. Maybe I'm delirious. Maybe I'm running a temperature. Let's actually go in here because we know for a fact there's oh my god. Oh, what a rabbit warren. We're never going to get out, are we? Jesus. Oh, look, stuff's been collapsing. Ugh. Oh, Jesus. Where the hell were we going, guys? Wow. Okay, we're never getting out of here tonight. Did I finish the pyramid? Not even close, Luke. Although, having said that, we've certainly made progress. Yeah, I like my stalactites. I'm going to leave my stalactites. I like them. They look pretty. We'll find some more nitrate. Did I give up on it? I'd never give up on anything, Luke. That's terrible, mate. We've been working on it all morning. Well, afternoon. Well, they're adding wolves, Geist. So you will be able to have like a pet at some point. A pet wolf, nonetheless. How cool is that? Not, I bet it's going to be one of those things that just gets in the way. It's just constantly falling in your spikes and you're constantly having to bandage it. They'll just be like pet wolves abandoned around the server after a week of release. Just finished the corner. We did a bit more than a corner. God, blimey, Governor. We remodeled a corner and then did one full face nearly. Well, all right, half a face. Oh, nice one, guys. Nice one. Yeah, get it, mate. Can't go wrong with it, dude. You'll have a happy weekend playing this, mate. Oh, I really need to go and get a drink. Let me just get a little bit of stone. I think this was a mine or a cavern to begin with. But I mean, we just use this for mining. I mean, this doesn't even go anywhere. All of Grumbutty Junction and the subterranean sort of travel system, the travel network, the metro. We've dug all that out. I don't think I'll be happy until I can ride a bear, to be honest. What about that? Can't see that happening somewhere. Fancy riding around Caliper City on bareback. For some reason that I can relate to that. I don't mean me naked, right, as in bear, riding a bear. I mean riding a bear.
Who was that man? I'd like to shake his hand. He made my baby fall in love with me.
How you doing, Jan? How's things? I think I need a bigger beard to ride a bear. You might be right, Rob. You couldn't ride a bear naked. It'd tickle your balls too much. You'd keep falling off laughing. You'd get 10 feet. I should imagine a bear's hairs are quite coarse. Imagine them rubbing around all over your balls. That'd be terrible, mate. You'd be laughing your socks if you keep falling off it. You'd at least have to wear a nice pair of Y fronts, I think. Oh, your copy didn't come. Oh, that's a shame. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Luke. There's nothing worse than waiting for a game that doesn't come on the day it's supposed to. I'll tell you what, Luke, I don't know if you've ever done it, mate. I've ordered games in the past that are supposed to come through the mail, so retail disc, and they don't. So I actually go into the city centre and buy it. So I end up with two copies. I have to send one back. very frustrating. Very frustrating. Bear hair is soft. I bet it fucking ain't, mate. We're out in the wild. I bet it's all full of, like, shit. Bear shit and twinks, and sticks, and berries. And scrotums from people that have tried to ride them in the past. I don't think they'd be very soft, mate, somehow. No one would mess with a naked guy riding a bear. I think you're right. I wouldn't. You've shot a bear. That wasn't very nice, was it? What was he doing? Was he sitting down with Eeyore having a pot of honey? You shot the motherfucker. That's terrible, mate. Christopher Robin is not going to be happy when we tell him about this, mate. You had a bear hunting permit? No way, dude. That was mad. I can't imagine shooting anything that big. That'd be really horrible. That'd be scary, man. What is it? Have you eaten bear then, Rob? What's it taste like, mate? What sort of meat is it? I mean, is it like a really, really strong sort of like meaty flavour, or is it actually not at all? The venison's quite a strong flavour, isn't it? I wonder what a bear burger is like. I could probably munch down on one of them, I should imagine. It's got a nice flavour. Is it very unique? You know, is it like nothing else? I don't actually seem to be getting anything except stone. It's quite unusual in Rudy's hole. Normally we don't go far before we hit like coal or nitrate or something, but would appear not to be the case. There's elk that drive around in Norway. How the fuck do they get in the car, mate? Fortune. They wouldn't be able to get in the seat. How would they open the fucking door? I call bollocks on that, mate. I'm sorry. There's just no way they'd get in the door. You found a picture of Grum and his vets, have a look. Oh, where's that opened? You fucker. Oh my giddy aunt. His fucking feet touching the ground, look. Yes, what the hell is that all about, man? That is crazy. He's got a beard, look, Rob. He's got a legit permit to ride a bear, that bloke. Oh, jeez. Do they have like a elk car insurance then, do they? Oh dear. Right, come on. Give me some bloody nitrate, mate. Oi, oi, Saveloy. Welcome back, Elagon. Did you have to go and do a couple of minutes work, did you, mate? Hello, beast. Tuna, mayo, and tomato. Ooh, that does sound nice. That does sound nice. Not actually hungry, but that does sound nice. Never thought of putting tomato in a tuna and mayo sandwich, actually. I normally have tuna mayo sweet corn on a sandwich or tuna mayo cucumber. I never thought of tomato. And I love tomatoes. Mmm. Still not watched Game of Thrones yet. Looking forward to that over the weekend. How much have we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I think we've got enough sand, haven't we? And we are bubbling up some extra cement, so don't think it will be enough. I think we need to load up before we head back. I think it was the last one, wasn't it, Geist? I think that was the season finale, wasn't it? The one that's just aired. Was it on Sunday last week? Is it like a sort of feature length or 87 minutes or something? Yeah, no, it's weird, Scott. You know what? I'm pretty sure I've never had tuna mayo with tomato. It's always been with sweet corn or cucumber. I should imagine some nice sliced cherry tomatoes would be nice. Yeah, same here, Dyke. There better be no goddamn spoilers in chat. I'll be a permaban. I deliberately sort of saved it. I didn't want someone want to watch it midweek. Oh, what the hell's that through there, look? I thought I'd try and save it to the weekend, so put the feet up. Might watch it early Sunday morning or something. Might treat myself to a nice bacon sandwich. Sausage, bacon, and egg. And then watch the grand finale. You not watched it either then, Dyke, no? Whereabouts are you at the moment, Dyke? Are you like literally like one episode out, or have you got like a whole season or something to catch up on? I went out last weekend to try and find, even if it was just like season one or season two or something, you know, first couple of seasons on Blu-ray, like in one of the cheap sort of second-hand shops. I just couldn't find anything. I might even consider a bit of eBay or Gumtree or something. I'd love to watch it all from, you know, in preparation for the next season. You know, watch the whole series again. There's so many things that I've forgotten. You know, some sort of seasons I've watched back to back. Some seasons I've watched, you know, on a weekly basis. It's just, I've just been really on off with it. It'd be great to sit down and like really get into it. Right back to the old Sean Bean beginnings. Crazy, isn't it, Super Z? It is. It's like it's been out for donkey's yonks. What's that, Lifeless? Holy shit, oh my days. What's up, mate? Oh my days. You're about half a season behind. You're gonna have a bit of a binge, are you? Yeah, I mean, it's, the way some of the characters have come on. Again, I'm not going to say too much because I don't want any spoilers, but, you know, I'll just say the smile, that those of you that remember it will obviously recall that. It's mad to think, you know, where they all began, isn't it? It's like super cool. It'd be really nice to go back with everything fresh from this season and sort of think of the journey some of those characters have had over the years. It's actually really hard to conceive sort of the fact that it has been running for that amount of time, isn't it? Sometimes, you know, you think it's just been running for a couple of 3 years, but yeah, wow. How they've grown. You not watched any anime either? That's unlike you, mate. What, just nothing new out, Daiko, no? I've hardly watched any films this month. June seems to have just been a bit of a... nothing special, really. So like I said last weekend, I ended up watching bloody Harry Potter Chamber of Secrets. We watched the first one a couple of weeks back. Quite enjoyed it. Good film. Well, they're all good films. I like a bit of Potter. Your days are so high, mate. we put a fair few hours into it. What's that, guys? The HBO Go app is free. If you have HBO through your TV provider, you can watch any and all the shows that's ever aired on HBO. No, I haven't got HBO, though. Has anyone seen any films recently? Anything decent been out and about? I want to watch that, is it The Conjuring 2? Because I've recently been watching a bit of Bates Motel on Netflix, which I've thoroughly enjoyed, although I stopped watching. I think I was on season... Can't remember, actually. Two or three, whichever one it is. It sort of tailed off a little bit, but I do like the actress. Can't remember her name. I think she's the sort of lead actress in Conjuring 2, if I recall correctly. You saw it recently, did you, Nari? Is it good? Yeah. Oh, nice one, dude. I can't remember the first one. I always like it when there's like a sequel or prequel to a horror film. It's always nice to go back, watch the first one, sort of early evening. Have a nice spot at dinner and then watch the new one. I always enjoy that. See you later, Lady P. See you later. Your sister saw it 2.5 miles from where the story is set. Where is it set then, Advina? I don't think I've ever watched the Vampire Diaries, mate. I've kind of struggled with a lot of the vampiric stuff that's been floating about over recent years, to be fair. There was something on... I can't remember the name of it. It's actually really good. It's on Netflix. If I try and explain it, there's basically a vampire and there is a werewolf. So nothing particularly unique there. I think there's been two series out. But it's got a very different sort of take on it all. Got a fantastic cast, amazing acting, a really spooky lead vampire as such, whose mom is like possibly one of the most evil bastards ever. It's got an extremely disfigured sister. You'll know it if you've seen it. Really good. He's basically how would you put it? Trying to think of it. No, not being human, mate. No, not True Blood. True Blood's totally different, isn't it? Hemlock Grove. Hemlock Grove. Pretty sure that's what it's called. True Blood. I watched True Blood for, I think, about 3 or 4... seasons, or certainly 2 or 3 seasons, and really enjoyed it. And then just a weird, it's like doing it a lot with some TV shows, just suddenly lose interest. Now, there's some shows like Breaking Bad, Game of Thrones that, you know, there's no way I'm not going to watch them. But other shows, I don't know whether it's because I binge on them a little bit because they're on Netflix. And, you know, sometimes it's like 5 seasons, sorry. And you can just get a little bit too much, can't you? You know. Yeah, Hemlock Grove's really good. It's got a very different sort of take on it all. Best vampire thing at the moment is What We Do in the Shadows. Again, I've not heard of that either. I'll have to look into that one then. Is that like a TV show, is it? Is it on Netflix? Don't worry, Rob. Is it? Does that not get the Daikoi seal of approval then? No. Dracula Untold. See, I know it's going to sound bonkers compared to some of all the amazing things we see these days, but I don't know if any of you have ever managed to get your hands on some of the really old Hammer horror stuff with Christopher Lee and Peter Cushing. Those old Hammer horror Dracula and Frankenstein movies. Oh, God, I could watch them until the cows come home, mate. I just don't know what it is about them. I just always felt like there was something really just captivating about those films. They're all black and white. I mean, well, not all of them. There's one, and I swear to God, to this day, quite often, maybe once or twice a year, I will try and find this film, and I've never found it. It's basically, I'm convinced it had Peter Cushing and Christopher Lee in it, and it was basically a film about an archaeological excavation in Egypt, which I'm fascinated by anyway. And it's essentially, they, you know, nothing unique, nothing new. I can't find my way out. They essentially uncover, obviously, a pharaoh's tomb, and they get cursed, and they come back to London in England. And this wonderful tale and sequence of events unfolds. And I found so many films that are so similar, but never that one. And I remember watching it on a Sunday evening. And it, I remember at the time just thinking it was one of the greatest films I'd ever seen, Peter Cushing and Christopher Lee. And I just can't, I actually think it might not have been them. You know, I was just such a big Hammer horror sort of film buff. I think I've just mistakenly made the connection that it was. One day I will find it though, and I will let you know. Like I said, every now and again, you know, I'll sit down for a few hours and just go through all the Peter Cushing films and, you know, wade through IMDb and the other sites that have got, you know, lots of info about the older films. I've still never been able to sort of recapture that and figure out exactly which one it is. No, I've seen them all. There's like The Mummy's Curse, and there's hundreds of these like old sort of Egyptian cursed tomb films from that genre and that era, but I've never been able to actually get that one. Right, now if you follow the torches, I think... Oh, shit, hang on. Torches are supposed to be on the left, right? Is this where we can... Ah, there we go, look. I remember in one scene, one of the guys in the desert, he put... Oh, shit, he puts his shoe on and there's a scorpion in it. That's one of like one of the more standout, less obvious scenes, you know, because the rest of it is very much about a mummy sort of wandering around killing people, but... I do remember that it was quite a nice special effects when he died, especially for the, you know, considering when it was made. Oh, what the hell? I just hit the bike. Now, how long ago did I say I was going to go and get a drink? About 3 hours ago. He's dead. Shall we head back with what we've got? Because the thing is, I could actually cook it up here, look. Got some iron in there, which seems, it does actually seem a bit of a waste, doesn't it? Should we? Oh, I can't. I was going to make some steel arrowheads, but I can't because we haven't got calipers over here. And like, you know, Sam Crow, loads and loads of people. Oh, no! Loads of people. The girlfriend's friends seem obsessed with that Sons of Anarchy. I've lost count of the number of times we've been sitting around, watching a film, going out, having some dinner or something, and someone talks about Sons of Anarchy. I literally watched about, 30 seconds of... All right, maybe 30 minutes of one episode, and it didn't get its fingers into me as such. I should really give it a shot because so many people tell me it's brilliant. Curse of Frankenstein. Trust me, Sam Cry. If it's an old Hammer horror film, I will have watched it. That's what makes me think the film that I'm actually talking about probably didn't even have Peter Cushing and Christopher Lee in it. I don't think it's a Hammer horror film I haven't seen over the years, to be honest. You worship the old universal monsters, Invisible Man and Wolf Man, are your favourites. You can't go wrong with any of them. Zombieland, yeah, Zombieland was a cracking film, wasn't it? You're right, Tyler. Hello, Annihilinth. Oh, nice one, Silverwolf. Hope it all goes well, mate. It's got his greasy fingers into me. Enfield story. Wow, that's so she's like, oh, wow. Sorry, what was I trying to do that? Oh, we're trying to make some. Oh, God, how am I going to get this out of here? Let's throw some stone in there. Let me quickly make some. Ooh, we need some frames, don't we? No, not that many, sir. Really? Come on there. Throw that in there. Yeah, I do like my horror films, but I've really noticed I can't stomach the ones that I sort of annoyingly to the girlfriend call like the horror porn. And by that I mean the stuff that I don't know if you've ever seen like Hostel or Hostel 2, for example, which were very much films that sort of rode the Saw success. But there's some scene. I mean, they are literally torture films. It's basically torture porn. I mean, I'm sure there's lots of people that enjoy that sort of thing. And I'm not, you know, I'm not here to say that, you know, that people shouldn't enjoy it. But it turns my stomach now. I don't enjoy it like I used to. You know, some of the stuff in Saw, I used to love. I thought that was brilliant. In fact, to this day, when I first saw the original Saw. That film ended and I just sat there just completely lost for words. Absolutely. The way the music kicked in, the way everything, that sense of sort of pace towards the end and the way you suddenly realise what had actually happened. I think the only other film that ever hit me like that was The Sixth Sense. It was just like, oh my God, I just absolutely have had the wool completely pulled over my eyes here. Absolutely brilliant. I was gobsmacked. And therefore became quite a big Saw fan, but as we know, it just became very much a cash-in. But, you know, I've still seen them all, so they got their money's worth out of me. But I have noticed a lot of films kind of just started doing these, like, really grossly graphic, sort of up-close torture things. And Hostel and Hostel 2 really struck me as just, like, quite frankly, just absolutely disgusting. I didn't find anything enjoyable out of them whatsoever. That's the sort of stuff the girlfriend absolutely adores, though. She loves that shit. Should I be worried? I'm not a big fan of Paranormal Activity. I sort of didn't mind the first one, and then I think it was the second or the third I watched, and literally I watched an hour and a half of this family doing not a lot, and then at the very end some woman came up behind him when he was on the sofa and looked like she might have killed him or done something to him. And that was it. I just thought this was just a complete waste of my time. Just literally nothing happened in this film. So I've kind of not watched those for a long time. Yeah, that's it, Annihilinth. Yeah, just gore for the sake of gore. I mean, the whole thing about Saw was that wonderful, wonderful twist at the end. You know, I just didn't see it coming, mate. I just didn't see it at all. I mean, I don't know if it was obvious to other folks, but God damn, that does look pretty damn cool, doesn't it? Human Centipede, never seen it, mate. Never seen it. I know Human Centipede 2 is on Netflix, and we've spoken a couple of times about watching it. But you've obviously got to watch the first one first, haven't you? I mean, you'd be mad not to. But no, not happening. Oh dear. Right, okay. So we've brought a lot of stone back. Let's get these furnaces bubbling up. We don't need to worry about wood for fuel, do we? We've got plenty of that kicking about. Let's have these burning non-stop 24 hours a day. Cement for the blood god. And I am going to get a drink. I swear to God, I am going to get a drink. I'm not going to be able to do that. That should keep going for a little bit. Let me throw these in. Actually thinking about it. Let's keep, we've got 3,000 cements, we need 6,000 stones. We don't need to put it all back. Oh, we got a nice little stash of iron as well. It's always nice to get that, because it means we can just keep upgrading another area of the spikes, can't we? So if we take 3,000 of that, 3,000 of that, that'll be another 3,000 cement cooked up. Or concrete, sorry. There we go. Bish, bash, bosh. Lovely jabble. So we really just completely dependent on getting more cement. If we just sort of... That's 1,000. So let's take 1,000. 2,000. Let's get it going. Go. So actually, there's nothing I can do right now. We might as well go back. I know it might not be the most exciting thing, but at the moment, we haven't actually got any concrete, and it takes us quite a while to make those half blocks as well. So, I mean, I've got 142 made, but that's just not enough for us to do like a big chunk, is it? I think by the time we come back, we should have sort of, you know, another 3,000 concrete. I think the decision's sort of been made for us, hasn't it, really? And it, you know, we can have a bit of a... We can have a natter, can't we? Our game's about stalking someone and rape. Thankfully, it got banned in several countries. What's that? What the fuck, dude? How's the pyramid? Do you want me to see it? I'll show you, mate. I'll show you. Elagon's been, like, absolutely just, like, fucking top of the world, super amazing, epic. He's even done us, like, a little how-to guide. Basically, when we came off yesterday, Elagon realised there was a major flaw in what I was proposing. So he's very kindly sort of walked us through what we need to do. I'm not 100% certain I know what I'm doing, but what I'm going to do is we're going to build like here, and then a block in, then a block there, then a block there, then a block there, and we're just going to keep building it in. The corner, I think I've just about got my head around. Oh shit. Get off my pyramid. Oh, we've changed it as well. We've smoothed off the internals, look, Jan. I wasn't convinced. I knew it could be done, but I wasn't sure I was going to like it with how the support pillars meet. But actually, it's grown on me quite a lot. I quite like it now. Have you seen The Descent? Right, that's something to do. There's a particular actress that I'm quite fond of. She's quite a young... Well, she was, because The Descent's really old, I think. Is that the one with the dark-haired girl that's just got really just the most amazingly unique features? And they all get locked in. Is it somewhere like outside the school grounds, and they basically get locked into a bunker? And you've got the obvious pretty girl. Then you've got this other. She's not like emo or gothy or anything like that. But she's got a very unique look. She was in something to do with some witches, like a witch's coven film as well. I can never remember the lady's name, but I always like her films. I think she's like a really good actress. She's not done a huge amount of stuff, though, I don't think. But I'm sure that's the one, isn't it? And there's like it's essentially like a vault door, a little bit like what we've got in this game. And underneath it, it's like some sort of bunker or something, and they're going to spend the weekend down there. Is that right? Or am I thinking a completely the wrong film, dude? Oh no! In which case, I'm getting confused, but I'm sure I've seen The Descent, mate. So it's ladies who go cave diving, and no, mate. So no, mate. Oh, let me make a note of that. Descent 1 and 2. All right, cheers, guys. I'll have a look at that. What was that? I saw someone mention something about Hemlock Grove there. The Descent is that cave mutant thing, right? I like that one. I'm sure I've seen it, but it's obviously not the one I'm thinking of. The one I'm on about, they're just like school kids, and rather than go home for the weekend, they decide to go down this sort of bunker and sort of hide away there for the weekend, but obviously all sorts of nasty shit goes down. Hemlock Grove has got a really good story, yes. It's a really nice, different take on it. You've sort of got like the rich vampire family. You've got the sort of traveler-esque werewolf guy. It's that really nice relationship between the two male leads. Sort of like a bit of a love-hate sort of relationship. I'd love them to do another series, because where it ends, it just leaves you wanting more. Like it's like, shit, how's this going to work out then? They get attacked by these crazy mutated people. Oh, I have seen it, Geist. I have, mate. And I am totally getting it mixed up with the other one that I'm on about. I'll tell you what I'll do, Geist. I'll try and figure out what that one is that I've seen. Because it's a cracking film. It's very old now. Well, I say very old. It's probably 15 years, something like that. Oh, shit, there's a deer there, look. Oh, come on. How did that not kill you? Oh, it did. He wasn't sure. He's having a think about it. He's like, I don't know if you got me there. Oh, go on then. I'll pretend to die. It's just called The Cave. Let's have a look, mate. I'll make it. So The Descent 1 and 2 in The Cave. I'll have a look at those. Thanks. Always interested in... look at that. Isn't that mad? It looks great. It's going to unload the bike. In fact, I'll tell you what, I'm going to unload the bike, then it's going to be nightfall. I am going to get myself a drink. I don't care what else happens between now and then. Thanks, Tyler. Yeah, it's not bad. It's not bad. We've put a lot of work into it and sort of preserving it. It all started off as such a simple little bunker, didn't it? And then it rapidly grew. I'm having a lot of fun with the pyramid, though, I have to say. This is really cool. And I have got some you know, if we do have to start a server for Alpha 15, I think a pyramid is where it's at for me. I've got some ideas on how to sort of create... Well, obviously, it's going to be a huge pyramid, but one that's kind of got defensive capabilities as well. I know a lot of you were kind enough to link sort of pictures of, like, the Mayan periods... What did I just say? Well, what I meant to say was Mayan pyramids, as opposed to the classic Egyptian pyramid. Quite interesting how you could... convert the Mayan ones to more of a base. Quite excited to start that. So, and it's good for me knowing I've got an agenda for another server, because what right now all I can think of is the tears and tantrums that are going to happen if I do have to start again. So, right, guys, I've got to get a drink. I'll be back in a jiffy. Right, I'm back. I need yet another monitor for Elegon's build. There's one bit I'm not sure about here, Elegon. I'm not at that point yet, but let's have a quick look. For anyone who's not got this, there you go. That's what we're looking at. Add the support between the beams. Yeah, add the ramps on top of the support beam. Yep, got that. Oh, coming towards the inside. So we've got to always be coming toward the inside. That makes sense. That's the bit I was... And then add the upside down ramps again. Start at the pillars and work towards the inside. Yeah. Okay, all right. I'm good to go with that. What happens if I fuck up step 7, Elegon? I don't think she's there anymore. It's step 7 that... We'll see when we get... I really want all the concrete so we can just, like, plow forward.